Hello and welcome, it's me, LinkingX2, and welcome back at Worlds. Continuing today, the final day of play-ins. The last two group seats are on the line in our series between Beyond Gaming and Hangwha Live Esports, also better known as Doggo Gaming and Shovi Live Esports. Also, we see the series between NA's Cloud9 and OC's Peace. If you liked the series so far, or just want to make me smile, hit me up with a like. Just a simple click to help me out. But without further ado, let's get into today's first match. In game 1 of our Beyond Hangwha Live series, we have to make a note, Mohan, Beyond's mid laner, is disqualified for sharing team intel for betting purposes. So, PK, their substitute top laner, comes in. Trinder and Gwen, as well as an Aphelios self-counterpick into Deft's Misfortune, mark Beyond's draft. And while we also see Aurelia and Fiora for Chovy, this sets us up for quite a spicy game. Beyond and Hangwha Live both come in with blazing guns, making plays top and bot, having the game quite even in kills. But, well, Hangwha Live still 2k gold lead due to the laners just farming better. Even after winning a fight 3-4, Hangwha Live can just slightly increase their lead. They get a pick on Doggo and nearly got Baron afterwards. Hangwha Live begins to get further and further ahead after the 23rd minute mark. Winning important fights, Hangwha Live is able to get the first W in the series. MVP goes to Deft, getting juicy kills, but also dishing out all the damage, doing well in lane, and overall having great positioning. He has been a reliable force in this first one. Coming to game number 2, Jarvan top, Chovy on Azir lets us thinking. But with an F Amumu, Hangwha Live's draft is quite good on paper, and especially in late game. But their solo lanes, Klett, Cannon, Vayne and Viego, Beyond looks for chaos and skirmishes instead of straight up 5v5s. Starting with a nice kill for Doggo, the good news for them come to a close end. After bot lane gets doven, Klett also incapable of farming versus Chovy. Add to that that Liang has some terrible TPs all game long, PK's Cannon gets farmed now, and now we understand why teams pick Jarvan into the red. Falling further behind in the mid game, Hangwha Live looks to dominate them even harder. B1 start desperate bot lane dives, Hangwha Live comes to collapse, it ends up with 2-5, Deft getting more and more fed. Beyond tries their hardest to get Doggo some kills or gold, but oof. Liang and PK, they just get gapped so hard, they're not even champions at this point, and also the team comp gap begins to shine with all the range and lockdown. The game explodes to an 8k gold lead before the 20th minute mark, even taking the first inhib. Beyond trying a desperate play with double TPs, they end up getting 2 kills, but also get aced afterwards, and are done for the game. Hangwha Live is just playing with their food here, and we have to say poor Doggo, his teammates really got outdone in this one. He personally also falling behind in gold, of course. And even though the Vayne is a good duelist, there are no duels here. There are no fair fights, with Hangwha Live having such a great gold lead from the start. Hangwha Live goes to 2-0 here, and the MVP goes to Willer's Lee Sin. While Husha had some good early games, Willer was a menace, dominating him and showed especially great synergy with his top laner Morgan, taking over the game. Coming into game number 3 here, MF for Doggo, PK gets his most played on, and we even see Fiora again. While Hangwha Live drafts more standard with Orianna and Lee Sin, Deft shows this Kai'Sa again versus Misfortune. Overall, we see many comfort picks for both sides. Willer again, with a better early game, gets to invade the buffs of Husha twice, and with Herald, he even gets Chovy the mid lane turret the 11th minute, setting up another 2k gold lead. And while bot this time goes quite nicely, PK is not as useless as before. Hangwha Live plays the map wonderfully. They get a 7k gold lead with many plates, turrets, and just all the heralds in the world. With such a nice lead, kills are bound to follow. And after this game started better than ever for Beyond, again after the 16th minute, the game is just over. Nearly losing bot inhib pre 20 minutes again, Willer just dominating Husha with Lee Sin, Liang's Fiora also not doing too well, and if we look at the meta, topside is just way stronger and more important than ADC, and especially if the ADC only is 20 CS ahead. 10k gold lead with Baron, Hangwha Live rolling over the PC's representatives in 3 games in a row. It got better in the end, and one has to think, would these games be a bit closer if Mohan, their regular mid laner, was there? Who knows? MVP again goes to Willer, while the laners on their own were already doing really good. The one who tips it in absolute favor for Hangwha Live is the jungler here, and with getting the kills after his hard work, he's able to duel his way through this game. And while Hangwha Live goes now into Group C with PSG, Fnatic and Rogue, we have a fun fact here. Deft just won his first best of 5 in 7 years. Coming to the Peace vs C9 series in game number 1. C9 this time with a fairly standard draft. Wukong, Syndra As counters to Ryze and Gnar, getting Lucian Nami as well, they get many prior picks. Peace on the other side start with just Aggression, Misfortune, Rakan and Xin Zhao to make things happen in the early and mid game. Lucian Nami even gets first blood killed by MF Rakan. Really bad start here for C9, but you can always count on Violet to over-aggress, and so yeah, it stays quite even in the bot lane. Peace finds some nice plays around mid lane and actually get a small lead for himself. Exchanging blows for a few minutes, the game stays quite close with next to no gold lead for either one. Violet and Perks are getting the kills for their teams. Getting aced and nearly losing Baron, C9 finds a deadly flank around the 25th minute. There's just too much dive coming in for the Misfortune to handle, and Tali is right, who has been doing some nice plays here and there, also being outdone by the range disadvantage. With all the kills coming in, Fotch sets himself up next to Perks as the main benefactor and carry for C9. C9 then finds a nice engage on Bobby, and all of poor Violet's team members get slaughtered, and with the extended death timers, the game is just over. Overall, a bit of a close game, but we have to note Zichachi looked really lost, something we haven't seen since day one. MVP in my book goes to Fudge, not only winning top lane, which is kinda expected with the counter pick, but also using the Wukong to great fruition in the teamfights and skirmishes, diving the backline or just zoning them out of fights, he became the true Monkey King. In game number 2, Peace gets something good here. Akali with a Shen top, Lee Sin and MF Amumu. Many contested picks and good ones. C9 goes for more comfort and counters, Aphelios Thresh and Gangplank Olaf. Another first blood happens on Sven, Peace bot lane again starts well. But a minute later, a 1-for-3 in the mid lane sets Blabber's key pick Olaf here up with 2 kills. More action in bot lane with TP's coming in, a bloody start to the game, 11 kills in just 6 minutes. Blabber gets even stronger with a Gore Drinker in 7 minutes ready to take the game into his hands. And Olaf getting strong is a huge problem for Peace comp. Blabber makes them feel the pain, dominating any skirmish, and while Peace commits multiple members to then die versus Blabber, C9's side lanes are getting all the farm, gold and turrets, catapulting the game to an 8k gold lead in just 14 minutes. And while Babib's Lee Sin actually looks kinda good, nothing really works out for Peace. The Akali Shen combo completely misplayed, falling 13k gold behind in 20 minutes. C9 also killing a Baron on site. Ooh, yikes. What a stomp. Started so nicely, but after Olaf got rolling, it all crumbled into pieces with an immediate loss afterwards. 21 minute game. MVP obviously goes to Blabber's Olaf. And yes, he got all the kills. And the champ is extremely potent early on, but he made extremely good use of the lead he got and was the driving force rolling over OCE. In game number 3, C9 this time with more special picks, Tryndamere as well as another Lucian Nami lane, Peace on the other side grab MF again and has a solo queue top side with Zed, Nidalee and Irelia. This time Sven gets the early kill, maybe a change in first blood causes a different result, or maybe it just means Peace gets slapped even harder here. And with Sven solo diving Violet and Fudge also finding solo kills top, the game starts even worse for OCE. 10 minutes, 3k lead with an arguably better scaling comp. It looks like after 2-5 game series yesterday, this too will be another short one. And with an 8k lead in 14 minutes, everyone hoping for a close series has to feel sad right now. And yeah, that includes me as well. More games, more fun, but C9 denies that. Seemingly returning to something even more than form, coming back from the O2 on day 2, achieving a nearly dancing Rift Herald and a close to perfect game in 19 minutes 30, finishing 21-1 in kills. A great performance from C9 overall. MVP goes to Sven's Lucian, doing great work in the bot lane, diving and then dishing out all the damage, having aggressive positioning but having the gold to do that. With this, the playing stage has concluded, and besides Detonation Focus Me making it out instead of Beyond, the results turned out as expected. C9 will go into Group A with Damwon, FPX and Rogue. Detonation Focus Me will go into Group B with EDG, T1 and Hungry Thieves. Hunger Life meets PSG, Fnatic and RNG in Group C. And lastly, LNG will face MAD, Genji and TL in Group D. Pick'ems will be available shortly, so don't forget to lock in your predictions. Thanks for watching and leave a like if you enjoyed it. And while you're at it, as I mentioned Pick'ems, what are your predictions for the group stage? Let me know down below. And before World starts on Monday, tomorrow we will look back at this year's play-ins meta. So maybe subscribe to not miss out on the upcoming content. Anyway, stay safe, see you around.